Yeah, you smell like a mole man.
What if I told you that being easy is... Wait a minute, I fucked that up. Abort.
What if I told you that I had AIDS?
Well, I would say have fun.
Good luck with that. Can we joke about AIDS? I know we can't joke about cancer because people are sensitive, but are we allowed to joke about AIDS?
You can joke all you want. I don't give a shit.
I don't know. People get really sensitive.
They get sensitive about a fart in their face. So what?
Well, I would never do that. That seems excessive. Excessive and mean.
No, that's like punching someone in the balls for no reason. That's a little excessive.
I hate these archers. I'm gonna go chew up the archers, because that's the job of a fucking rogue. Okay? Good?
Sure. No, I think my main problem with Hammerwatch...
It was a statement, not a question.
Oh, okay. I figured as much. But I think my main problem with Hammerwatch, when it comes to making videos for it, is that there really isn't much to say about it.
Yeah. It's kinda... Well, that's why I haven't, like, tried to bring the conversation back to the game, because it's just like, yeah, we're killing skeletons.
Yeah,
you're a cleric,
I had
I'm
the
a
same
thief. What
issue
do you need
with Hammerwatch when I was playing it with my friend Zach. There really isn't much to say about it, and it's not because the game has nothing to say about it, it's just that it's very simple. You walk around,
yeah.
You kill things, and you collect planks, dosh, you get upgrades. It's as a simple game can get. And it's nice.
Yeah.
I really like simple games, because I feel that games nowadays try a little too hard to be mysterious and deep and advanced. Like, who cares? Just make it playable. I don't care how deep it is, as long as I can understand what I'm doing.
I understand what I'm doing most of the time in Hammerwatch. Sometimes there's chests and walls and weird things that you gotta go through.
Yeah, but in Hammerwatch there isn't much to know in the first place. Which I think is a very good thing for it. Anyone can pick it up and play at any point in time. It doesn't take any skill or effort or anything to get into it. You could use a patch.
Ooh.
This should
That's
help.
It. That's what we got. All
we're
right.
On a budget for Faith.
Kill! Ah! Fart, fart, fart!
However, I feel for some games, having nothing to say could be a detriment.
Like, Metroid Other M.
I hear so many people bitch about that game, but I have no idea why.
Just because, like, Metroidvania implies that they don't give you much instruction, and in Other M, they're, like, constantly like, okay, now you have to do this, and it's just not...
So it's like a
it's
complete
It's not a good feel for Metroid. Yeah.
Hmm.
They completely hold your hand the whole way, and it's like, nobody likes that. Which gives me some hope for the gaming community, because a lot of times people are like, oh yeah, it holds your hand, but it's great. That's one of the reasons I got so into Stardew Valley. And Terraria and Dig or Die is because they just fucking throw you in there and go figure it out.
But
you'll figure it out.
That's not always a bad thing, being held by your hands. I think it depends on the game itself. For games like Terraria or Minecraft or Dig or Die, for instance, if you're being told what to do all the time, it's not really a survival game anymore. You're just playing by the objectives.
Yeah.
Which obviously no longer works with that
adventure.
Game, and it might actually be something that I would want to play. Which is like having cats and dogs living together. Mass hysteria.
Mass hysteria! What are we gonna do? Get shot by an archer in the face, apparently.
But sometimes I feel that a game does have to tell you what to do. I think RPGs would actually be the best example of that. Because if you have an RPG that literally tells you nothing, well, what are you supposed to do? The best thing you can do at that point is just quit the game and fucking delete it.
I think that's, like sandbox. Less RPG, more sandbox.
I guess so, but I think if you're gonna have certain elements in the game, like, let's say a storyline, for instance, you're gonna need to have some level of hand-holding as well. Because you need to make sure that the player actually pays attention to your game and doesn't feel completely fucking bored or lost.
Which does happen a considerable amount of the time.
There is nothing worse than a game that's boring or confusing.
Like Rust. Wait.
Is it boring and confusing?
I was confused when I started it up recently. It's not really boring, just because there's always somebody trying to kill you and take your stuff.
Nah, well, that's one reason why I'll never play it.
You don't like PvP? I thought you were into Counter-Strike.
That doesn't mean
you
I like PvP.
You shoot people with a gun.
I like Counter-Strike because that's awesome. All you really do. You just shoot shit. Although most of the time, if I'm gonna shoot people, I'll just get some friends and play some gun game. So I can hear them complain that the game is not treating them well.
It never does.
No, apparently me headshotting with a shotgun across pool day map is bullshit. But, well, the map isn't too big, so what do you want?
And yeah, if you're clicking on the head, like a shotgun will probably hit you in the head.
You're not even supposed to click on the head, you're supposed to aim for the base of the neck for the best results. Because that way, if you're gonna use like an automatic gun, your recoil is gonna start jumping straight for the head.
Yeah, that's true.
Especially in 1.6 with that silenced M4. Holy shit, the headshots are rolling!
Winning!
Monster kill. Kill.
Money shot!
Ludicrous kill. Fucking love
Ludicrous.
That shit. Those quake sounds are always funny. Oh, look.
Throw them into anything.
Two apple. But wait, secret. Oh, it's this bullshit again.
Bomb.
Nope.
Bomb.
It's okay, I got this. I'm Puzzle Master.
There it goes. Oh, no.
Well, speaking of...
Oopie-doo.
Speaking of puzzles, actually, I can't wait till I actually get to Amnesia, because it's an action puzzle game, not a horror game. As people would like
Amnesia?
To say.
Amnesia?
Yeah, Amnesia of the Dark Descent. Oi.
I think I played Outlast, and then I stopped, so I don't know what Amnesia's like.
Eh, people say it's a horror game, but I haven't seen anything horrifying about it every time I played it. I mean, there's some people, there's some monsters that show up that look like they have vaginas for their faces. But that's about it. There's nothing scary about that.
Yeah, that's sexy.
Looks kinda gross, actually, but that's about it. Plus, it pisses the shit out of me, because every time I see a monster, my first instinct is not to run away like a bitch, but throw something at it.
Yeah, kill it.
Yeah,
kill
it. But you can't kill anything. And that annoys
me. That's one thing that got me out of Outlast. I was just like, I don't know. I don't know about this game.
Yeah, that's what I don't like
Why
about
can't
most
I do
horror
nothing?
Games too. I wanna kill the fucking monster. I don't wanna run away from it all the fucking time. Let me fight at least.
I think the helplessness is you know.
Maybe it's
what
scary
helps
for
it be.
Some people, but for me it's fucking annoying. I mean this
I think I was scared of Outlast. I played it on Halloween like last year or the year before and it freaked me out a little bit. I said I'm not coming back to it, so...
Yeah, but in Amnesia's case, there's so many barrels and boxes and rocks and all kinds of stuff you could throw at them. And you throw it at them, and nothing happens. It just bounces off of their heads like rubber balls. And you're just...
Yeah, throw a wheelchair.
You could probably find one too, actually. and you just throw that thing, nothing happens. Like, why even have other stuff there?
To troll you. To troll you specifically.
I think so, because the only monster that you can kill in Amnesia is the one that's invisible.
And invisible?
Yeah, it's some kind of monster that trudges through the water in one of the cellar sections.
That's stupid.
It's a bit weird, but it's the only thing you can kill, and you can't even tell if it's dead or not. The only way to know that is if it makes some yellow splooge if you hit it. But that usually is pretty hard to notice too, so good luck getting the fucking kill.
Ah.
Sounds like you got wrecked.
Yeah, I have like twice the amount of deaths that you do now. It's not going well.
Oh, you died. Well, we got another damage boost.
Damage, damage, damage! Ah! The thief will make the damage.
Feel the burn.
Oh, do you feel it? Do you feel it? I'm feeling the burn. I'm feeling the socialism.
Oh, you mean feel the burn.
Burn!
I don't get people are so upset about Sanders.
I don't think people are upset per se, except people that want Sanders instead of Hillary.
Well, I think everyone wants something instead of Hillary.
Yep.
Because at this point,
that's what I'm about.
At this point in time, anything is better than fucking Hillary.
Well, yeah, she's a criminal.
Oh, it's not just that. She just spouts all kinds of dumb bullshit all the fucking time. And gets a variety of fucking dumbasses to help her out as well. If you don't vote for Hillary, there's a special place in hell for you. Yeah, there's a special place in hell for you for being a fucking idiot.
Yep. I know I'm right. You don't have to. You don't have to tell me who to vote for. I did the research. Okay.
I think this. Oh, I think I see where we need to go. I see a lot of monsters over here. And we didn't explore this entire region either.
No, we found a door and said, "Holy shit!"
That's a lot of fire.
Yeah,
but
fucking wrecked him.
What perplexes me the most is the hatred for Trump.
Well, people have been told to hate him. It's not really anybody's fault.
That's how it feels, actually. It's like people are told that they must hate him because reasons, but they never really specify any particular reason. I mean, he doesn't seem to be the brightest torch in the fucking tunnel, but. Let's be honest here, if there is one thing he does right, is piss off just the right kind of people.
Exactly, that's why I love him.
And at the very least, if you don't support Sanders for whatever reason, vote for him at least, because everyone else is either a corrupt cunt bag or Hillary.
Honestly, if Sanders got in versus Trump, I would have a hard time voting. Because I do like a lot of what both of them had to say. Trump would probably win out in the end just because he's not scared to talk about Islam and stuff. But apparently that's hateful or whatever.
Well,
like we were talking about earlier.
Well, he doesn't give a shit.
Yeah, that's why I love him. Because he's like me. He doesn't give a fuck. He wants to say the truth. And if you don't like the truth, too fucking bad. Because it's the truth.
It's not just that. The media also really hates him because of that. And it's mostly because he can't be bought that easily.
That's the most wonderful part.
Yeah, he's fucking rich. Who's gonna waste millions on him just so that he wouldn't talk a certain way?
Nobody!
Nobody with the right mind intact.
He probably wouldn't sell out anyways.
No, he'd probably just take the money and be the same thing anyway. I'd do that in his fucking place.
I would too.
Take the money and just act like I always do. What are they gonna do? Sue me for not being corrupt?
Yeah, all of a sudden, you like have to tell everybody, we bribed him, and he didn't listen. It's like,
unsurprisingly enough, people would probably do that and they would be considered not guilty nowadays.
True. I mean, some of the stuff Hillary's gotten away with, it's like, yeah, I'm not really surprised at anything anymore.
I'm glad to hear that the overwhelming majority of people do not like Hillary at all.
Yeah, there's just the few people that A, want to see a woman president, or B, dislike Trump to that point. But really, if you talk to them about why they dislike Trump, they'll never really give you a fully formed reason. They're just like, he's a racist. It's like, okay.
Okay, great. So he's a racist, but how exactly is he a racist? Has he said anything in particular that proves that he's racist?
Nope, he just talked about Islam, and that's enough for people to be like, oh, you're
Islam
terrible.
Is not a race, so that's already a point off the fucking racism card. And Muslims are also not a race. So that's not a thing to be racist about. Another thing, if you're gonna say...
Oh, but he tweeted a picture of a taco bowl on Cinco de Mayo.
Oh, the 7-Eleven. I've seen the greatest firefighters. The great Cinco de Supas massacre of 7-Eleven.
I wish I had like a good answer for why people are fucktarded about it, but I don't. So I just, I roll my way and hope that people will see it my way, and if not, I don't really care if they're...
I think the answer
judging.
Is pretty simple here, because they're fucking
shit.
Retarded. There really isn't much else to say in this case.
Yep, we love retardery. America does love retardery.
And what other options are there to vote for? Jeb Bush? Who the hell is he even?
Fucking Keish and Ted Cruz and a bunch of other people that are
Ted Cruz.
Lifelong politicians.
I only remember Ted Cruz because somebody said he looks like the Zodiac Killer.
I saw a picture of him like next to a tranny that looked just like him, and I thought that was the funniest thing I've ever seen. He does have like a really ladylike face for a man.
And as for Jeb Bush, I only remembered that he exists recently because I was attracted to an article of some person who has the uncanny looks of Jeb Bush, but unfortunately is not, who was holding down a thief while waiting for the police. He also beat her up a bit. Coincidentally, the thief turned out to be a black woman.
Well, go ahead, beat her up.
I normally wouldn't really think much of it, but I found that to be very interesting because she was trying her damnedest to get away, even as much as begging for mercy. Like, fuck's sake, you tried to rob someone who's about 75 years old, and then you managed to hurt the poor person at the same time. No, you don't deserve mercy.
Yeah, forgive me, bleh. It's like you're only sorry because you got caught, fucker.
Yeah, if you didn't get caught, you wouldn't even bat an eye as to what happened.
Yep,
fucking
exactly.
Cunt.
So I say lock him up, throw away the key.
Oh, speaking of keys, we got the silver key, which means you can go back and unlock another passage.
Did we miss one?
Well, we had one here, but he couldn't open it because we were lacking a key. Oh,
that's right.
This game loves doing this kind of shit, throwing you all over the place. It's like Turok 2 in a way, actually. The first three levels are just fine. While a little confusing at first, it won't take long to figure out how to get through them. But then you get to level 4, the Lair of the Blind Ones. And holy shit, is it a pain in the ass.
They do you up good.
First of all, the Lair of the Blind Ones contains the blind ones who are not quite blind. So, that's a problem.
That's false advertising.
Well, it's not exactly false advertising, it's that their sight is justified by not being exactly sight, but rather their super advanced hearing. So you can pretty much see you with their ears anyway, so what's the fucking difference?
They don't have eyes.
They do. A singular, non-functional eye.
Oh, that's weird.
Fucking Cyclops people living in the caves, which is another problem. Caves, they're fucking small, dank, and they go all over the place. Navigation...
Yeah, you smell like a mole man!
Navigation in that level is horrendous, even with the map.
It's like, the forest.
It's worse than that. I haven't played the forest, but I can imagine how bad it might be there.
Yeah, the fucking dudes come and kidnap you, and they're like, you live with us now! And then you gotta find your way out of the cave, which it really isn't that bad, all things considered, but... Trying to do it without light is yeah. I don't like dark cave. Dark cave, no fucking light. I think in my Pokemon Nuzlocke, I went through rock tunnel without the flash TM. Oh yeah.
What the fuck is a Nuzlocke anyway?
It's basically a rule set where
hold on a moment. I have to address this very important issue. We are interrupting this program because somebody got butthurt after that question.
What's a Nuzlocke?
How dare he say that? How dare he not know everything on the internet? Well, I'm sorry, but I don't give a shit.
It happens.
I mean, I don't even know what most of the Pokemans are. I know a Pikachu, whatever it's called again. Charmander, I think that's the name.
Yeah, he's a good one.
What's that other one?
He's a fan favorite.
Snorman, that's the name, I think.
I love Snorlax.
Yeah, that guy. He's fat.
Yeah. He's fat. It's not his fault. It's his genetics.
Mudkip. Yeah, that's a very famous one. Last I checked.
Yeah, everybody loves Mudkip.
But that's about it. That's all I know.
Everybody loves Mudkip.
So, who do you like Mudkips?
Who told you that?
Well, yeah, what's that Nuzlocke thing? How do you nuz the lock?
You nuz it, well, okay. We'll start at the very beginning. There was, a Nuzleaf, and somebody named it Nuzlocke after their lock from, Lost. And then you basically take it through the entire game and try not to let it faint even once. And if it faints, then you have to put it in the PC box or release it. I put it in the PC box just to have a sweet memory of my friends that have passed.
So basically, and, it's just an arbitrary challenge mode.
Yes, precisely.
Okay, but why is it made in the first place? Like, what's the point of it?
So you can be better bros with your Pokemon, use Pokemon that you might not normally use, like, because you're supposed to catch the first one that you find on the route, so you're not, like, grinding for stats or things like that. You just kind of accept your Pokemon as they are, just like the TV show would have you do.
The TV show. Oh, right, they did show that at some point on the channel that I never watched.
They're like, you gotta love your Pokemon no matter what. They're gonna be your best friends for life.
Out of all four channels that I had as a kid, that's the one I never watched because it always had the shittiest shows and the shittiest of movies.
You don't like Jumanji? Jumanji!
The cartoon or the movie?
Both. I watched both. I loved Jumanji.
The movie was alright.
Jumanji's got a cool lore to it.
The deepest lore. but the cartoon, I don't know, it looked fucking weird.
It definitely did have some strange animation.
Fuck's sake, we didn't open that shit yet. I knew we missed something. We didn't open the boss door. And I'm pretty sure I saw a way to the boss lock. I could have sworn I saw it somewhere on the map. I see it.
Where'd you go?
Just hold on. I'm gonna rush this.
I can't hold it!
Good. I don't know if the skeletons are gonna follow, but if they will, well, fuck them. Oh, they stopped.
I got a delicious fan of knives. Oh, here's the boss. Yeah, okay.
Yeah, we kind of missed the lock for it. There's the rest of this place as well, but fuck it.
Yeah, we got a boss. We gotta fight a boss.
Boss, 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 boss. Okay.
Boots, boots. Boots, Fatni. Okay, and then.
Well, this isn't the boss.
No, it's false advertising. False advertising. Okay.
Might as well destroy all these things. Is it Mr. Bones?
Super combo.
Oh, I bet it's Mr. Bones.
Better not be. Fucking dick. Oh, that's a 55 combo, son.
Oh, it is
combo,
Mr. Bones.
Son.
I honestly thought it was gonna be a giant slime.
I must break you.
That's not your line, you cunt. That's my line.
Ow, ow, shit, fuck. I don't like it.
By the way, as soon as you mentioned lost, I heard somebody groan in misery.
How many hours of my life must I waste?
That ending was horrible. Or so I heard. Yeah. I didn't see the ending.
The ending was terrible. It ranks, I think Dexter was the only worst ending that I know of.
What do you mean, Dexter? His lab got blown up? Oh, I could have sworn he kept DD out.
I was thinking about Breaking Bad when you said that. I was like, no, it's a different show.
Oh, I know which one you're talking about. The dumbass cop show.
Yeah. He's like, oh, look, I'm analyzing blood spatter shit. It's like, okay, that's nice.
Yeah,
nice for you.
Yeah, that's such a cool idea.
Oh.
A murderer is investigating murders.
He'll get away with it every time.
It's like it's like the predecessor of the even dumber idea of a zombie working as a detective.
Is that a thing?
I believe it was a thing at some point in time, because I did hear about it.
Zombie detective? That sounds so awful.
It sounds fucking retarded.
Oh my god. I'm getting wrecked so hard by this fucking guy.
Well, of course, he's cheating. Look at him drop bombs.
Yeah.
My faith is
bombs
my weapon.
From the ceiling.
Suka, blyat.
God damn it.
Knight's Glen. A passage has been revealed.
What a dick, dude.
He's got the beam schlong.
Beam schlong.
Well, at least you didn't need to stick any hands into any holy anus.
You could if you want, still.
I can't believe I'm the only person who saw this movie. Oh, Jesus. Now I have to explain. Fuck.
Yep. We got time, don't worry.
Yeah, we have time, but the better question is, do we have enough space for all of the inappropriate language flags that we're going to get?
Who's gonna tell on me? Nobody. Everybody knows that Dayton Does is not the channel for the children.
Well, the children are gonna show up and they're gonna be very upset. Then I say that the movie that I was just referencing that had the holy anus in question is called Gay Niggers from Outer Space. I'm not kidding.
Oh. That's probably why I haven't seen it.
It's like, real. I've seen it. And it's fucking funny. Stick your hand into the holy anus.
I don't want to.
And surprisingly enough, it's not even a porn movie.
It's just one of those movies that are offensive to be offensive for offensiveness sake.
It's the weirdest fucking thing you'll ever see, that's what it is. Basically an intergalactic group of gay, well, blacks have been sent down to planet Earth to eradicate all females and save the men from the evils that the females present, apparently.
That's true.
It's like reverse feminism.
That's true. I could see that one coming.
It's like a movie about reverse feminism, except it's funny. Especially like the scene when one of the so-called agents meet up with the female for the first time. Female! Female! Die!
That's so sad.
He fucking zapped her out of existence. And apparently...
just because she's a female.
Apparently...
don't you know that we have enough of this violence against women nowadays in the media?
But the weirdest part is, once all the females have been zapped out, the world entered peace. Global peace.
Imagine
and
it.
And everyone was so happy.
Nobody had anybody to impress anymore.
And we were sharing fucking kebabs and whatnot, or some other crap. It was weird. I'll say that. It was the weirdest fucking thing I ever seen. I only came across
it. You know, Russia banned kebabs and shawarma. Shawarma.
I came across that movie by a complete fucking accident while I was looking for James Bond.
I'm sure you were.
Well, it's not the first time I encounter things that I wasn't looking for in Pirate Bay.
That's true. The internet's got some,
I mean, you look for...
some issues.
You look for something innocuous, like, let's say Assassin's Creed, and you're probably gonna find at least one porn movie.
The Assassin's Creed porn movie.
The Assassin's
Creed. The Apollo
Creed.
Apollo Creed porn movie. It's about that boxer. You know what I'm talking about?
Yes. From Rocky.
Yeah, it was a movie. People liked it.
Eh.
So I heard.
I didn't like Rocky.
Yeah, I'm not too into the Rocky movies. Oh my god, what the fuck was that?
I think it was just a shiny ball.
What is it doing here?
Shining.
You don't belong here.
It's shining.
Unacceptable! Now I'll break all this stuff. So you can
pay
for your
crimes. Did I say shining? Oh yes, it sounds like a clever segue to talk about something completely unrelated to Hammerwatch.
Yeah, y'all like Stanley Kubrick, right?
No, I was actually thinking about the Shining Force.
Oh, well that's vaguely more related.
No, it's a game.
Stanley Kubrick Shining is like nothing. Well, yeah, that...
have you ever played The Shining Force?
I've definitely heard of it before.
It's a Sega Genesis RPG. Tactical RPG. Doesn't ring any bells?
Mm-mm.
No, that's not a big surprise. I only discovered it recently myself. But I had a lot of fun.
Shining Force. Sounds like America. America, land of the free, home of the awesome.
Now the funny thing is, I like the story out of all things the most in that game, and it's the last thing I ever go for in a game.
How'd you get down there?
Oh, I died.
Tits.
But yeah, Shining Force has a pretty fun story. It's not the most fleshed out thing, but I like it for what it is.
Yeah, I don't really have high expectations for video game stories these days. Like, if it has one point where I'm like, wow, they said something really smart there, then I'll be like, okay, it's got a good story.
If anything, I would compare the story of Shining Force to a much simplified version of Dragon Age Origins story.
Ooh,
they're very similar,
like,
but
Origins.
Shining Force is much more simple. Oh, that chest is now available to pick up. Later.
I got this. What to do?
Then I pick up Shining Force 2, and it's fucking annoying. Because it is... well, it's a sequel. As much as a sequel can be in its case, because it has nothing to do with what happened in the first game. It's like a completely different story happening.
It's like a prequel!
I don't know at what point in time it's happening, but it feels like it might actually be a prequel at some point. Or a very distant sequel, like it was the case with Mega Man Legends.
Yeah.
Which...
I thought that was pretty cool, though.
I should probably give that game a shot, because I've seen a few Let's Plays of it. It looked pretty fun.
Yeah, I think I watched, I forget who it was. Game Face Max, maybe? I don't know. One of the people that I don't really watch anymore.
Would be my first Mega Man
Not
game.
Because of anything they did. But because I have no time to watch things anymore.
It'll be the first Mega Man game I ever played, that's for sure.
That's sexy. You should start with Mega Man X.
I don't really want to.
Mega Man X is easy. If I was trying to be mean, I'd say start with Mega Man 3. Or even the original.
Would it be surprising to say that the only SNES game that I played so far, aside from Smash TV, but I don't count that as playing, is actually Castlevania 4.
That's a pretty good one.
Yeah, I got it as a recommendation. And by recommendation, I mean you should totally play this or else I will strangle you in your sleep. And
that's an order.
It's a pretty strong recommendation, I'd say. And I gave it
fair,
a shot, because I heard good things about it, and yeah, it's a fun game. I really liked it. It's just that... Well, I didn't quite manage to keep my cool for the most of it.
Those are the best episodes, though, where people just fucking flip out and go, you know what? I hate this game. I'm done.
I couldn't contain my madness by the time I got to Dracula, because he was kicking my ass hard. What was I expecting, really? I haven't played any other Castlevania game up till that point, and still haven't, really. So, like my friend Jack said, it was as if all of the Castlevania decided to unleash its bullshit in one go.
Well, if you, if you haven't had a taste, I mean, it sounds like a good idea to me.
Yeah, but ever since then, I played it more times, and every new playthrough I had was easier and easier, and I really liked the game for that. Among other things, of course.
Well, of course it's easier. You did it already.
Yeah, but I think it's a very solid game.
Yeah, I love fucking Castlevania series.
I
got really into it on Nintendo DS.
I especially love it for the moonwalking. Oh, yes. Every staircase.
Get on them stairs.
Yeah. Every staircase I got on, I had to moonwalk.
Sounds about
and
right.
And I still do that out of habit. It's important. It's what gives me strength.
Oh. Oh, the heels are here. The heels! They came!
Pills here. Pills. Haven't played Left 4 Dead in a while.
Yeah, I think Belmont has some fucking... some good lore there.
What has?
Oh, definitely. Belmont. Castlevania, yeah.
Well...
The Belmont family.
I gotta say that some of the later Castlevanias, like what's it called again? Symphony of the Night or something like
Symphony
that?
Symphony of the Night. Yeah.
Well, the ones that took up the Metroidvania approach, I didn't like them at all. Particularly
Why?
Symphony of the Night. It's fucking huge! Who has time to play that fucking thing?
Ooh. I do.
It's fucking monstrous.
I got all the time in the world.
But it's fucking monstrous. I've seen a few playthroughs of it, particularly the one from Game Gallows. And what, they got like 80 parts and they still didn't beat it, or did they beat it already?
I didn't
check the last time, but if they didn't, well, it just proves my point. The fucking game is massive. And sure,
that's
a
good
thing, I suppose, because a lot of times I complain about the games being too fucking short. But that one is too fucking big. For me, at least.
It's a careful balance, yes. God damn it. Eat the fruit.
I like the length of Castlevania 4. It was not too short, but not too long as well. By the time I got tired of it, I already was at Dracula.
Yeah, that's about the perfect length for a game. I think in one sitting, 2 to 3 hours is about right, but a lot of games are fucking way longer than that. They're like, yeah, 60 hours.
Most of the Sega games back in the days were about an hour long only.
That seems right to me.
It's the best length, I would say, for most of the games. Because most of them are just pretty basic stuff like beat-em-ups or racers or some other crap.
Yeah.
Then you get to stuff like Lost Vikings, and then you realize that, well, unless you have a lot of time on your hands, you're not getting out of it anytime soon.
Dude, I love Lost Vikings.
I love it too. Which is why I did a full blog playthrough of it on my channel, where I did it all by myself.
I did it all!
I beat the entire thing by myself.
That's pretty good.
It wasn't easy, I'll tell you that much.
Yeah. I could imagine.
I did it mostly because all other playthroughs I've seen of it either had 2 people playing or 3 people playing. So I wanted to have a little challenge. And boy was...
You can do it!
Boy was it a challenge, but it only proves the point that you can beat it by yourself. It's just gonna be... Maybe...
Yeah, you just gotta want to.
But my thing is now, I don't really know if it's gonna be harder to do it by yourself or easier, because I do remember playing it with my friends as well, and well, they're not too well coordinated most of the time.
It happens.
I mean, that's how I figured out that after about 15 deaths, you get the message from 4 who shit talks you.
Don't do it! I'm a good person.
No, he's like, I'm 4, the god of Vikings or whatever, and I'm very disappointed in you guys. How dare you die so many times?
Do you get a better ending if you don't die?
No.
Oh. Lame!
You just get that message when you die too many times.
Oh god.
Hell, at one point, the Vikings themselves will be like, one of them will be shit-talking your skills, and the other ones will be like, oh, don't say that, he's very sensitive. Which I kinda like, actually.
At least they know that about me.
He's a very sensitive player, don't say that. Still, I gotta say, some of the levels in Lost Vikings, especially when you return back to the spaceship, they were fucking brutal.
It's a brutal sort of game.
Oh shit, there's somebody's triggering a trap. You need to go there and see what's doing it.
Slimes.
Alright.
Dead slimes.
These fucking slimes.
Fan of knives! Fan of knives! Haha!
We'll be needing this.
Okay.
I recall one level in particular in Lost Vikings where you had to shoot an arrow across about 2 screens of length. And you had to position your Vikings in a way so that if you switched from one to another, the screen would scroll along with the arrow.
That's impossible.
It's quite annoying to do it, but it's not too difficult actually.
I don't want to do any of that.
Yeah, I'm not too fond of it either. Still, it's a very fun game to do. Except one world, but we don't talk about that.
It's just like Hammerwatch. It's a fun game, except for some parts.
We do not talk about the Backy Worlds.
Backy World? Yeah. Is that where you go to chew Tobacky?
I don't remember if there was any level differences between the SNES and Genesis version. I think there was, but I don't remember. I do know, however, that Wacky World was, well, for lack of a better term, wacky. And also one of the longest fucking worlds.
Yeah, I don't like that. Just give me something easy.
Oh, but that's Lost Vikings for you. It's not meant to be easy. It's a good puzzle game.
Well, Yeah, because back in the day, like, you paid this much for a game and wanted a certain amount of playthrough from it.
Well, I'm glad it is the way it is, but I hear its sequels weren't that better.
I don't think I've heard anything about Lost Viking sequels. Maybe in fucking, like, World of Warcraft they had some references, but I thought it was just one game.
I believe there's at least two sequels, but I don't remember. I know there's Lost Vikings 2 somewhere, but I don't know if we have any more than that. One thing is certain, there are sequels.
I like sequels. When's Hammerwatch 2 coming?
Never. I'm a little wary of sequels, because whenever somebody makes a sequel, that franchise is now becoming subject to the law of sequels.
Like Sonic!
And the law of sequels for the uneducated plebs is the more sequels are out there for the franchise, the more likely it is that the franchise will start to suck massively.
Is that true? Elfpool, Manipool, move speed.
Can it be true? Well, yes. I mean, I think Sonic franchise is the best example of that. By the time they got to the year 2006, that's where they hit the rockiest of bottoms.
I still fucking make jokes about Sonic 06.
Everyone does.
Oh!
Damn. It's a joke of a lifetime.
I want to play it on my channel. Hey everybody, we're here playing Sonic 06 because I hate myself.
1, 2, 3, 4. Goodbye, goodbye, see you again. Goodbye, goodbye, see you, my